On the Republican 2016 trail, outrage.
I disagree with their decision. I believe Obamacare is bad for Americans, bad for the country.
Even though the Supreme Court's decision was written by Chief Justice John Roberts, a Republican appointee, conservatives like Mike Huckabee spoke of an out-of-control act of judicial tyranny. And every GOP presidential candidate renewed promises to dismantle Obamacare.
We still need to replace and repeal all of Obamacare.
This election in 2016 for the House and the Senate and the White House will give you a chance to stop Obamacare.
Despite all that strident rhetoric, behind the scenes in many Republican quarters, there is a giant sigh of relief. If the Supreme Court had gone the other way, ruled the government subsidies for Obamacare are unconstitutional, it would have been up to the GOP-led Congress to deal with the fallout for 6.5 million Americans still required to have health insurance but can't afford it without government dollars.
Crocodile tears are flowing here in our nation's capital.
Ted Cruz tried to gin up his Tea Party base by calling out his own Republican establishment.
Quietly celebrating the court's decision. If they believe this issue is now settled so they don't have to address it, they are sorely mistaken.
In fact, conservative activists say there will be even more pressure on the GOP-led Congress to vote again to repeal Obamacare, especially the Senate, now led by Republicans.
The grassroots activists, the rank-and-file Republicans, the Tea Party activists, all those people are asked by the party, give us your votes, give us your energy in walking precincts and getting out the vote, give us your money, do all these things, and we will repeal Obamacare. And then it doesn't happen.